This is a Swede Speaks.
It is time for Last Week in Islamic Terror again. Before we get started with that, let me just mention that Ramadan started today. This most likely means terror in the weeks to come. I hope that I am wrong. I would also like to thank the good people at the religionofpeace.com website for their hard work to keep track of the statistics. So now, without further ado, let's get started. On Monday, May 7th, 2018, there were 5 dead and 3 injured, and those were in Sirte, Libya, 2 dead when Islamists opened fire on civilians. In Narbal, India, 1 tourist dead and 1 person injured when a pro-terrorist mob stoned their car. In Koh Safi, Afghanistan, 2 dead and 2 injured by a Taliban landmine. On Tuesday, May 8th, there were 19 dead and 28 injured, and among those were in Pamukkale, Afghanistan, 3 dead and 6 injured when terrorists fired on a family home. In Hafiz Gudai, Afghanistan, 2 dead and 19 injured when an Islamic group sent a mortar into a residential neighborhood. In Mel, Iraq, 3 dead and 3 injured when Mujahideen set off a bomb near an oil field. On Wednesday, May 9th, there were 42 dead and 57 injured, and among those were in Van Lavain, Somalia, 10 dead and 10 injured by a suicide bomber at a market. In Kabul, Afghanistan, 7 dead and 17 injured when suicide bombers hit a police station. In Badghis, Afghanistan, 8 guards dead and 3 persons injured when the Taliban attacked a voter registration center. On Thursday, May 10th, 5 dead and 2 injured, and those were in Katakat, Afghanistan, a civilian was murdered by Islamic State. In Verulam, South Africa, a Shiite imam was stabbed to death at his mosque by sectarian killers. 2 persons were injured. In Savki, Afghanistan, 3 dead, beheaded by the Islamic State. On Friday, May 11th, there were 45 dead and 29 injured. And among those were in Bala Buluk, Afghanistan, 23 dead and 3 injured by a Taliban ambush. In Farah, Afghanistan, 11 local police officers killed by the Taliban. In Wadayir, Somalia, 4 shot to death and 2 injured during an al-Shabaab home invasion. On Saturday, May 12th, there were 22 dead and 22 injured. And among those were in Kirkuk, Iraq, 6 dead killed by radicalized Sunnis. In Dashti Arshi, Afghanistan, 9 dead and 5 injured when the Taliban attacked local security personnel. In Paris, France, 1 dead and 4 injured by a man yelling praises to Allah while he stabbed passersby outside an opera house. And on Sunday, May 13th, there were 30 dead and 92 injured. And among those were in Surabaya, Indonesia, 13 dead and 43 injured when a family that included 4 children carried out suicide bombings of 3 churches. In Jalalabad, Afghanistan, 10 dead and 42 injured when suicide bombers carried out an attack on a tax office. In Mashlaka, Iraq, 2 dead and 3 injured by Mujahid bombers. So, last week, there were 168 dead and 233 injured. Last month, April 2018, there were 899 dead and 940 injured. So far, this year, 2018, there were 4,187 dead and 4,882 injured. And last year, 2017, there were 15,788 dead and 14,361 injured. So, as we can see, there were 168 unnecessary deaths and 233 unnecessary injuries last week. And Ramadan started today. Sadly, that will probably mean more Islamic terror in the weeks to come. And yes, I certainly hope that I am wrong. But this is what it looks like. Islam creates problems in the West, Islam creates problems in the East, Islam creates problems in the North, and Islam creates problems in the South. Islam creates problems in Islamic countries, for instance Afghanistan and Somalia, and Islam creates problems in non-Islamic countries, for instance India and France. The one thing that all these terrorist acts have in common is that they were inspired by the teaching of Islam. Thus, it is reasonable to conclude that Islam is the root cause. That's what needs to be understood and addressed, And that's what I have to say about this right now. I would like to thank everyone who supports my work. And if you like what I do, if you think what I do is important, please consider sending me a dollar or two, or 10, or 100. That's always greatly appreciated. Also, remember to keep me in your prayers. Please follow me on Twitter and Gab, and like and share this video. I will return next week with another episode of Last Week in Islamic Terror, as there sadly has already been some this week too. Also, check out my midweek livestream tomorrow, on Thursday, at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 2 p.m. Mountain Time, 3 p.m. Central Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, 9 p.m. Western European Time, 10 p.m. Central European Time, 11 p.m. Eastern European Time, and midnight further Eastern European Time. So, until next time, have a nice day, and God bless.